I kind of became more familiar with the program after I realized how monumental it was for me. I learned about Count the Kicks actually at my 28-week appointment. And so it was something that was kind of always in the back of my mind. I learned, mostly it seemed to me, you monitor for, you know, kind of consistently each day. And so I generally didn't take under 30 minutes is how fast I could get it normally. And so I kind of went on my pregnancy and didn't have any concerns. And I got home and I thought, oh, that's weird. I don't really feel her moving too much. The next morning I woke up and I'm like, okay, I'm gonna do my kick count, because I still wasn't certain. And I definitely got less than, I think, 5 in a 2-hour period. There's just something inside of you as a mom that you can't describe to other people. And, you know, I remember saying to my husband, gosh, I just feel like she's moving a little less, and okay, you know, and it didn't trigger anything to him, but it was really, you know, it was bothering me. And I ended up speaking to a coworker of mine who's also a mom. She had a baby 6 months before I was due with Nora, and I just said, gosh, you know, I just have this feeling something's, you know, like she's just moving a little less, and I don't know, maybe I'm being, you know, you write it off. Maybe I'm being silly. And, you know, she was pretty encouraging, like, you know what, just go get checked out. If that's what you have to do to make sure that everything is okay, then do it. And so it just had this like nagging thing from, again, the night before, where I saw a little decrease and then was really seeing a lot, significantly less movement. Whereas, you know, again, within a 2-hour period, I can't even count one time that she moved. And so, but I think if you have something like the app that kind of keeps you aware of what your normal baby's activities are, and then you're paying attention a little bit more when, you know, things change, that will definitely bring attention to that. You know, you need to be seen if something seems abnormal. On my way home from work that day, I called the first nurse, and, you know, we spoke about how many times I had heard or I had felt her kick in the last hour or whatever, and, you know, she said in the last 2 hours, and I'm like, nothing. And she's like, well, then you need to come in. And I got here, and they put a Doppler on me, and, you know, you could hear the heartbeat, but everything was good. And so they said, okay, we're just going to monitor you for a little while. My understanding is I had some D cells, and you know, everyone kind of came running into my room. I think Dr. Swanson was my surgeon, and so he came in, and, you know, he said, well, I think you need a C-section, ready to become a parent in, you know, 20 minutes. And then, yeah, I went right to C-section right after that. So I think it was probably within 2 hours at least of being here that I was a mom. So, you know, you kind of just get that gut feeling that won't quite go away. And even I was doubting it, but I thought, you know what, I just need the peace of mind. And then it turned out that you know, during the C-section, her cord was wrapped around her neck. I just couldn't feel anything but lucky.